great video. I just wanted to touch on a couple of things that I made comments about made comments in the comment section, obviously. And I know you saw at least one of them. I was talking about how boring heaven would be, because it's going to be full of dull twats, essentially. It's going to be full of the kind of people that have been preachy, sanctimonious bastards their entire lives. And, of course, they made it up to heaven. This is all hypothetical, of course, obviously. And, you know, what does heaven look like? Heaven, well, I take my cue from the cartoons. It's clouds. It's a cloudscape, essentially. It's not a landscape. It's clouds. There's some pearly gates with St. Peter outside. Everything's white, apart from the pearly gates, which are pearly. And they're not in Pearly. They might be from Pearly, and they put them there. Maybe that's why they're called the Pearly Gates. I always thought it was Pearly, P-E-A-R-L-Y, though. So I imagine they're supposed to be made of pearl. It's an unusual building material, isn't it, to say the least? Although it's heaven, you know, the rules are different there. So you've got some gates, you've got a bloke sitting outside, presumably it's Peter. He decides he's coming in, like, you, no fucking sandals, mate, fuck off. Jesus wouldn't get in, would he? So, and then there's a lot of people wandering around in white robes, some of whom are playing harps, some have wings. And, you know, I've been on a plane a few times, and when you look out the window, you see the clouds, you think, that's pretty amazing. Well, look at those clouds. But for eternity, clouds, nothing else. Eternity is a long time, and then it's a long time after that, and then some more. And I really think that that's too long just to have clouds to look at and to sit on. And then is everything made out of clouds? I mean, in all the pictures I've ever seen of heaven, there's just clouds. So do you want a chair? Do you make a cloud chair to sit on? Do you want to watch a bit of telly? I've got a cloud telly over here. Read a cloud book. And what about books? I mean, I know all these boring bastard born-again Christians only read the Bible. And so in heaven, what happens there? Because, you know, there is only the Bible that God wrote. Are they allowed to read anything proper when they get up there? Like, you know, some Irvine Welsh or Charlie Brooker books or, Stephen King. Anything. I mean, you know. Comics, Viz. Are they allowed to read Viz? Because I'd be cheesed off if I went to heaven and I wasn't allowed to read Viz. Private Eye, and again, you know, car magazines, Top Gear. I'd be most annoyed. So I've just got this notion that perhaps, you know, hypothetically, of course, you get a choice when you go up there. You get to the pearly gates and St. Peter says, so you can come in if you like, you've got the option. Like, oh, I've got the option. What are the options? So he says, well, you can go to hell. I'm like, well, the hell's already nasty. It's full of horrible burning. And he gets, no, calm down. It's not actually like that. There's heaven, which is for all the sanctimonious twats, born-again Christians that have been homeschooled. Or there's hell, which is for all the funky cool people who like booze, like to shag birds, like to race cars, all that kind of stuff. And, you know, it's bloody great, actually. I wish I was down there. I got stuck with this job. And I'd be like, oh, great. And you go down to hell. Down. I don't know if you go down. I think that's just a biblical, some kind of notion. So you probably just go across the street. It's probably like when I went to fucking Disneyland. There's Disneyland on one side. There's California Adventure on the other. It's probably like that. You go one way, you go to Disneyland. The other way is California Adventure. It's my guess. So you've got the clouds on one side, and then you've got all the fun. And then what is hell's landscape like? You know, I imagine it's just like a big city. And then there's probably some countryside. You know, I'm sure. But I'll tell you something. I bet there's an awful lot of interesting people there. All the really interesting people there. Because apparently to get into heaven, you've got to give yourself over to, you know, do you accept the Lord Jesus Christ into your heart as your Lord and Saviour kind of bollocks? Well, most people don't, do they? They just go, I'm going to die. You know, I mean, what if you're Ayrton Senna? Ayrton Senna used to go on about God a lot. He used to talk about how God was in the driving seat when he won a race. He used to thank God. He would all but get on his knees and thank God. And he would talk about God in the post-race interviews. But that man died at 200 miles an hour, hitting, you know, a wall, and a piece of suspension from the car went through his head. Did he have time to give himself over to Jesus? So he's probably down in hell too, you know. There's people that have done all kinds of wonderful work and been wonderful human beings. And they would, according to the bullshit rules of these frickin' born-again Christian Nazis, the most boring people on the planet, all these incredible, intelligent artists and scientists, video game people, teachers, even, you know, people have done great work against suffering in Africa and so on and so forth, they're all going to go to hell, supposedly a bad place. Well, hell sounds like all the definitely cool people are going to be there, all the massively cool, funny, intelligent, educated, witty, clever, sensible, in a good way. Decent people are going to be down there, and all the shitty, sanctimonious arseholes are going to be in heaven, being with nothing to talk about. What are they going to talk about when they're in heaven? They won't have anything left to talk about. All they had to talk about on earth was God and being born again, and isn't being born, and isn't God great? Well, they can carry on doing that in heaven, can't they? And go up there and kick, you know, kiss his ass. I said kick his ass. Kiss his ass until their heart's content. Meanwhile, the party people will be having fun, shagging each other, boozing, making great art, rocking and rolling. It'll just be fabulous fun. Of course, it doesn't really exist, so it doesn't matter.